Another throwing video for your delight. So this is a bit of a practice as well. So we're going 2 pound clear. And we're going to go for a tall, narrow-necked vase. That's the plan anyway. Make sure you're in the picture. That's it. So here we go. Tall, narrow-necked vase. So corner. And centre down. Oh, I lost my concentration a bit there. That went a bit wonky. That's not a very good centre, is it? I'll push that way. So slow the wheel away a bit. And then we'll break in. Open it out. There. Compress the base. So collar it in a little bit, slow the wheel. And we'll do our first lift. So right down to the wheel. Head. So it just gets our first bit of clay up. Collar it in again. On it. We'll go for a second lift. So we'll push in, get that lump clear. All the way at the top. And compact that top. So how we doing? So we've got a bit clear down here still to get up. a little bit slower. Right, so we'll go for our third lift. So push in from both sides, get that lumper clear, and start the lift. Try to keep the even pressure. Don't go too slow, don't go too fast. Join your hands together when you can. Maintain the pressure all the way to the top. Exhale. Not too bad. So, collar this in a bit. It's starting to flare out. Now, to gain a little bit extra height, what we'll do, we'll basically you choke it in all the way from the bottom to narrow it, but as you do that you lift, so you're basically thickening the clay out a little bit as you raise it up. You gain a little bit of height off it as well. So now we've got plenty clear, looking down on it, plenty clear to work with. So go a bit faster for my liking, I think. So are we still in the picture or just in the pictures? So now might have to stand up for this bit. So going to do one final lift. So put our hand in there, push in at the bottom, get that clear, lift it. Whew. There you go. Don't think we're top's going a little bit wobbly, but we'll sort that out. We'll just choke them in a bit. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to throw it against this rib, this wooden rib, to smooth them off. Oh, we're looking in shape there. So it's pretty straight up and down. So we've got the bottom of the trim, got that. We come up here like so. So this bit I'm pretty happy with, the base. So that'll trim nice. So from about here I want to start to chalk it in to narrow it. This is the bit I always struggle with. So go from there, so it's going to be trimmed there, it's going to come out a bit. So from about there, this is where I want to start to narrow it in. And as you narrow it in, the clear gets thicker. It starts to like ripple a bit. And when it does that, you have to start pull the clay again. To thin it out. Now, I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to get rid of that ripple. Now, before we get too far ahead of ourselves, trim that off. Compact that top. Again, we're getting there, we're definitely getting narrower. Stretch that up. Right, I'll get a wooden rib on this now. I'll sort of shape that. It's going okay. Now, metal ribs. Metal rib, metal rib, metal rib. Not a fan. But got out there. Finish this fella off. Clean some of our water out of the way. And we're done for time. 16 minutes, right. Probably should have done this a bit earlier on, but so I've got that smooth, now I want to go really narrow. That shape. What's that look like? I think we'll cut our losses. We'll trim this top. Great. Sorry, I think I was holding my breath there for a bit. Get carried away in the moment. So, I think that's the top done. Get rid of some of this water. And we'll trim the bottom. Not too aggressive, because we don't want to knock it off centre. And we'll do it cheap, the easier way. We'll just undercut. That's us done. A bottle, or well, a bottle, a narrow necked vase, which is, I always struggle with the narrow necks, but that's turned out half decent. It off and we'll get it on a bat. Might regret this, but 1, 2, 3 through like so. Dry hands, lift it off onto there. So there you go. A bottle. We'll get the camera down for you to have a look at before we sign off. So there you go, a thin-necked vase, and we'll trim the base a bit, I think, thin it out. We'll put some fluting on it. I think it'll look good with some fluting on it. Maybe it's there and the neck to match. Well, it turned out okay. So again, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Hope you learnt something. I'm sure I know I did. Always do. Like, subscribe, comment. Catch you all in the next video. Cheers. Bye bye.